welcome to Mama Reacts, the show where I scroll through YouTube and judge people on things that I probably couldn't do.
So the first one that we're watching is Jackie Beats Filthy Whore.
Oh, good. And it's like a parody?
I don't know.
Well, we're gonna find out. Oh no, it's fully a parody. This is a Britney Spears parody, and she's wearing that Justin Timberlake ramen wig, but it's gonna be May wig. This is a million views. That's impressive, considering there's nothing really interesting happening here. This is like case in point of like, leave Britney alone. Like, she's just making fun of Britney Spears and calling her a whore. I don't know. Free Britney. No, I don't like this. There's like, a generational gap with drag, which is like, yes, Jackie Beat is legendary, but like, is this really that interesting? Is she doing anything like that isn't just making fun of Britney Spears for being a woman who like had a hard life? Like, there's no like real comedic value in that video. I'm not impressed with Jackie Beat's music career. Maybe this is just the peak of it. But the fact that it has a million views makes me think that this might be all that she has to offer. This is 2007, so this is also early YouTube.
Yeah, this is the time that the parodies were thriving on YouTube.
Right.
Everyone made parodies.
But that's what I'm saying, is like, drag back then was like that easy. We could be doing bad parody videos, but I think that was like one of the first things that we said when we started Trish's YouTube was like, we are not parody queens. Although I guess we're parodying YouTube itself.
Okay.
I don't like it.
Next. You don't. I think she might actually have talent in this one. Like, I mean, not that the other ones don't, but singing talent.
And I've seen some of her music videos. Did you see her last music video where she's like got this whole new drag king alter ego? It's very rock and roll in this wig. This almost has the opposite problem of the Jackie Beat video, which is like, very talented. Do I want to listen to the song? No. Like, would I sit around and listen to this very inspirational music? No. Oh! The reveal. Drag can basically go, like, two ways in, like, the public eye. There's, like, drag that is like Jackie Beat, misogynistic, like over the top, not just campy, but like mean. And then there's like also the drag, which is like so inspirational and like you're being yourself. And like,
that was like,
I think this is like too far the opposite direction. Like, I don't care about this. She's very talented.
Yeah, she is.
And she's very pretty.
This is like we are the comedy queens.
Yeah, no.
And this is the pageant queen.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's right. The other girls smell like beans. I want someone who smells like beans.
Okay. Bounce it like a basketball. Like a basketball.
Stop. Bouncing that booty from left to right. All the haters in the room looking forward. I first thought that was Laganja Estranja. It's Friday night. Grab your girls, hit the floor. She's a white girl rapper, also problematic. You shady girl, but the way you move your body amazing. Maybe the moral of this is that drag queens should just stop making music. She's thick, I do like that. She got a nice ass. She can dance. bounce that booty like a basketball. You ain't got no. I do also appreciate drag music that's not about being a drag queen. Or like at least she's making music just for the sake of making music and just happens to be a drag queen, and it's not just like, we are the drag queens, or like Britney Spears was fat once. Like, this is at least her trying to do something artistic, so props to ya. Okay, I know nothing about Pablo Vittar except that she's gorgeous, but I immediately stan just from this. I think Pablo has an advantage here because I don't know what she's saying, so I'm not paying attention to whether her lyrics mean anything. But my immediate reaction is that this is a real musician. She's gorgeous. Her voice is great. This production value is hot. Pablo Vittar, like, invented Come to Brazil. Why wasn't she featured on that song? Come on, Alaska. What do you think her rate is? I want to book her. Pablo Vittar has restored my faith in drag music. I take back everything that I said. You can be talented. Part of the great thing of drag is that, like we're doing, we just kind of make content and hope that something sticks. And I think that should be what drag is, that you like just make shit until something works. But this person's like exceptionally talented and just happens to be a drag queen. That's like a different kind of being an artist.
Right.
And like, why not? Like, why not use drag as like a tool to like get yourself out there when you just happen to be like this like kind of femme faggy, gender fluid person? We stan. I don't know her that well, but I will be going home and listening to Pablo Vittar. Ooh, I'm gonna blast her on the car ride home. Our last contribution for the night is a newly released single from San Francisco local queens, Amorites, Adriana Roy, and BB Sweetbriar. I've been very intentional about not listening to this yet because I'm super excited to react to it right now.
Ready?
Yeah, do it to me. Okay. And please let us produce your music video. Should I put in both headphones for this? Oh, it's a cover. Yeah.
If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell.
You know the ghost. This must be BB. Yeah, yeah. I think so.
I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone and I just can't get it back.
Oh, nice. They get the harmonies in there. Is that Amora? Second one? Amora does a karaoke night at the Port Bar and it is poppin', and she sounds so good always. She's very talented. This is what I'm saying. It's like music. They're just singers. They just happen to be drag queens. I'm into it. All right, what's Adriana Roy got for us?
If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts would tell.
That's bitch work.
Just like an old school movie.
I can't wait to perform this.
In the castle dark.
Kind of sounds like the Queer Eye theme song.
You know the girl.
Are they on tour?
Gotta book them.
Amazing. I loved it. Color me impressed, ladies. I am ready. We at Trish TV are formally offering to shoot your music video. Let's talk. I love it. I think drag queens should only make music if they are already interested in making music before doing drag. It shouldn't be secondary, because then you end up in Jackie B territory for...
Well, you end up in a lot of the Drag Race girls.
Conchita. Yeah, or like Drag Race girl territory. Thanks for joining me here. Like and subscribe. I didn't do that with my last wig on. What else do I do? Now I will sing to you. If you could read my mind. Cut.
Thank you for watching Trish TV. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, please support us on Flipkaws. The link's in the description. Bye!